Why, hello there. Yes, you. I'm talking to you. Do you know the difference between meiosis and mitosis? Would you like to know the difference between meiosis and mitosis? Splendid! Now both mitosis and meiosis sound the same, but do not be fooled. Foolishness leads to confusion, and being confused is like a rocket to the face! Let's clarify.
Like reproduction in humans, cells need to multiply in order to survive.
Mitosis is the exact replication of cells. In order to replicate, the cells are blueprinted through RNA and DNA. The process is complex, way too much to explain in this short video. However, the simple way to understand the basic process is through strands within the cell called chromosomes. They are the building blocks in the cell. They contain the blueprints for cell division. Now, meet Bob. Bob is a good man. He's a good Samaritan, not a lot on his mind. He wears green armor. Bob knows his chromosome count in the somatic cells. It's 46. See, only somatic cells go through mitosis. These cells are called diploids. The chromosome count in humans is always the same. However, what makes humans different from animals is the amount of chromosomes in their cells. Now, meet Mr. Hoek. This is another mild-mannered good Samaritan with little on his mind. His society is more evolved and expands into the far reaches of space. He grew up on a different planet where conditions are far different from Earth's. His chromosome count is 56, and as you can tell, his appearance is much different. There are four phases in mitosis: prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. The chromosomes will be represented by these cones. The cell wall will be represented by these barriers, and the nucleus will be represented by this circular object. Now, here's a cell before mitosis. The chromosome count is 4, and the nucleus is formed. The first phase, where the nucleus is gone and the chromosomes condense, is called prophase. You will notice that the chromosomes have doubled. However, they have not yet detached. The doubled chromosomes line up at the equator, where the invisible fibers in the cell attach to them, ready to pull the chromosomes away from each other. This is called metaphase. The invisible fibers pull away at the chromosomes. The chromosomes detach from each other and start to spread apart. This phase is called anaphase. The next chromosomes are called sister chromosomes. This is the cell separating from its sister cell. This is called telophase. The result of mitosis is an exact replica of its sister cell. This will remain constant. Each cell will contain 4 chromosomes. So, do you understand this? Very good, let's move on. So imagine this on another scale. The plasma grenade represents one cell. It doubles through mitosis and becomes 2 cells. And those cells double and become 4 cells. And so forth. Each cell contains the same amount of chromosomes through mitosis. The cell's appearance remains constant. Meiosis is different. Don't let that get you stuck. The process, like the name, is very similar. A parent cell that is about to go through meiosis does the same thing as a cell ready for mitosis. The chromosomes condense and replicate. The parent cell splits apart in the next phase. Each cell contains two unsplit chromosomes. The daughter cells split apart in the next phase. Each cell contains two split chromosomes. So, if you could move right along to the display, I can show you in scale how it works. Now, imagine that this tank is a parent cell about to go through meiosis. As you can see, its appearance is very large. It just went through the first phase of meiosis and became these two jeeps. These two jeeps are much smaller than the tank. Both of the jeeps split and then become four ATVs. Now remember, products of meiosis are called haploids because they are reproductive. If you were to look at the ATVs under a microscope, they would be sperm. Sperm are responsible for the miracle of life. I will not go into detail on how life is conceived. This is not that documentary. Thank you for watching this short presentation on the difference between meiosis and mitosis. It was filmed using Halo 3.